Hey guys, welcome to all of you on our channel, that is Achieve IAS. So friends, as you know that on our channel we are targeting the exam of civil services, and for that purpose we have started multiple series on our channel that target your prelims as well as mains. So in this video we will be talking about a daily current affair based MCQ series, in which what we do, we daily discuss your MCQs from current affair perspective. So what we do, we daily pick up 10 questions from the current affairs of the day and we discuss those MCQs. So today is 23rd September, so let's see what are the questions for today. So first question is, consider the following statements related to liquid funds. First, this fund is supposed to be maintained by all the scheduled commercial banks to avoid bank runs. Second, they are regulated by SEBI, that is Securities and Exchange Board of India. So which of the above statements is correct, friends? Let me tell you that the correct answer is B, that is second only. So Securities and Exchange Board of India has proposed new rules related to liquid funds in its recent board meeting. So what is a liquid fund? So it is basically a category of mutual fund which invests primarily in money market instruments like certificate of deposits, treasury bills, commercial papers and term deposits. So mutual fund is an investment vehicle made up of a pool of monies collected from public investors, and the pooled money is used to buy other securities by professional money managers. So it gives small or individual investors access to professionally managed portfolios of equities, bonds and other securities. So these are the details. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements related to 5G technology. First, it has fast data transmission because of its low latency. Second, South Korea is the first country to officially launch this technology. So we have to choose that which of the above statements is correct. Let me tell you friends that both of these statements are correct. It is yes, it is a fast data transmission technology, and also South Korea has become the first country to officially launch this, and it is the fifth generation cellular technology that, apart from increasing the downloading and uploading speeds over the mobile network, also reduces the latency, that is time taken by a network to respond. So 5G will provide a download speed of 1 Gbps, that is gigabyte per second, so which is at least 100 times the existing data speed. So it increases the energy efficiency and offers more stable network connection. So how it can ensure energy efficiency? So for example, if you want to download a file, and suppose you want to download a large file, then obviously you will just click and it will be downloaded within seconds, and then you can turn off your device by not wasting much energy. So it also offers more stable network connection, so it has a wider area in the frequency spectrum, so range of frequencies that will ensure no network congestion. So it will have a kind of wider area in the frequency spectrum, so enough space will be available. So in addition, it will also ensure connectivity to a full circle, that is everything is connected to every other thing. So the standards for the usage of 5G are defined and driven by third generation partnership project. So this is your second question. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, which of the following terror organizations has been listed under Unlawful Activities Prevention Act 1967? First, Lashkar-e-Taiba, second, Jaish-e-Mohammed, third, Jammu and Kashmir Islamic Front, fourth, ISIS. So we have to choose that which of the above statements is correct. Let me tell you friends that the first, second and the third statement is correct. This Lashkar-e-Taiba, Jaish-e-Mohammed and Jammu and Kashmir Islamic Front, they all are listed as unlawful, that is terrorist organizations. So this list has been picked up from Ministry of Home Affairs website. So you can visit this website. So in files you can check that which of the organizations are listed as terrorist organizations. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements related to Ocean Conservancy. First, it is a non-profit environmental advocacy group based in Washington, D.C., United States. Second, its efforts to ban whaling resulted in the International Whaling Commission adopting an international moratorium on commercial whaling in 1982. So we have to choose that which of the above statements is correct. So let me tell you friends that both of these statements are correct. Basically, this Ocean Conservancy is a non-profit environmental advocacy group, and it is based in Washington, D.C., United States. So its effort to ban whaling resulted in International Whaling Commission, so which adopted the international moratorium on commercial whaling in 1982. So both of these statements are correct. So Ocean Conservancy, as I've told you, it is one of the few organizations that help protect wildlife in the ocean. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements related to pyrolysis. First, it is a process of combustion only in the presence of oxygen. Second, the gas and liquid obtained as a bioproduct can be used as fuel. So which of the above statements is correct? We have to choose that. Let me tell you, friends, that only second statement is correct. That is, so the answer would be B. That is second only. So pyrolysis is a kind of combustion in the absence of oxygen. So it is not in the presence of oxygen, rather it is the absence of oxygen, or the material burnt under a controlled atmosphere of oxygen. So it is an alternative to incineration. So gas and liquid thus obtained can be used as fuels, and pyrolysis of carbonaceous waste like firewood, coconut, palm waste, combs, etc. The yield charcoal along with products like tar, methyl alcohol, acetic acid, and your acetone and fuel gas. So gas and liquid is released as a byproduct. So which can be used for example, charcoal can be used for energy purposes, tar, methyl alcohol. So all of these can be used. Fuel gas can also be used as a fuel. Next is, consider the following statements related to e-cigarettes. First, it can be a best replacement for traditional cigarettes as it does not contain any harmful chemicals. Second, US FDA has Food and Drug Administration has recognized it as official replacement for traditional cigarettes. So we have to choose that which of the above statements is correct. Let me tell you, friends, that both of these statements are incorrect. So the answer is neither one nor two. So the solution is D. So what are e-cigarettes? They are battery powered devices that work by heating a liquid into an aerosol that the user inhales and exhales. So e-cigarette liquid typically contains nicotine, propylene, glycol, glycerin, flavorings and other chemicals. So what are the concerns? The products are not registered as nicotine replacement therapy products in India. So e-cigarettes usually contain nicotine, which makes product addictive. So e-cigarette cause health hazards for the youth, young adults and pregnant women. So a number of metals including lead, chromium, nickel and chemicals like formaldehyde have been found in aerosol of some of these ENDS with the concentrations equal to or greater than traditional cigarettes. Work as tumor promoters. So traditional cigarette manufacturing companies are having parallel e-cigarette like device making industries. So those who manufacture these traditional, they have set up a parallel e-cigarette like device making making industries. This growing hub in India is though under regulated. So lack of knowledge about negative effects of nicotine and easy accessibility of these products make the youth prone to addiction. Next is 7. Teesta is a transboundary river shared between which of the two nations? A. India and China. B. India and Bangladesh. C. India and Nepal. D. India and Bhutan. So friends, let me tell you that the answer is B. That is India and Bangladesh. So Teesta originates from Kangse Glacier, Cheramu Lake in Sikkim. Most of its catchment area lies in India and it enters Bangladesh, joins Brahmaputra and ends in Bay of Bengal. So it forms a kind of tributary of Brahmaputra. And then after Brahmaputra, Ganges and Meghna, Teesta is the fourth largest river in Bangladesh. So let's move on to the next question. Next is, which country is called the land of thousand lakes? A. Denmark. B. Sweden. C. Finland. D. Iceland. So the answer is C. Finland. So this country is called called as land of thousand lakes. So why it has been asked? Because our external affairs minister, that was a former diplomat also, he is in Finland currently. So next is, Solomon Islands is sandwiched between which oceans? A. North Atlantic Ocean and South Atlantic Ocean. B. Solomon Sea and South Pacific Ocean. C. East China Sea and South China Sea. D. None of the above. So the friends is answer is, friends, it is easy. Answer is B. That is solution is B. So you can see this Solomon Sea. So here you can see this South Pacific Ocean, and this is your Solomon Sea. So you can here also see your Solomon Islands. So let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements related to sun's dark spots. First, sun's dark spot is an outcome of sun's magnetic cycle. The second is the dark spot is hotter than surrounding area. So we have to choose that which of the above statements is correct. Let me tell you friends, only first statement is correct. That is, it is an outcome of sun's magnetic cycle. So sunspots are basically areas that appear dark on the surface of the sun. They appear dark because they are cooler than other parts of the sun's surface. So temperature of a sunspot is still high, around 6500 degrees Fahrenheit. So sunspot, though they are relatively cool. So it's because they form at areas where magnetic fields are particularly strong. So please note this, where the magnetic fields are strong, there the dark spots are found. And these magnetic fields are so strong that they keep some of the heat within the sun from reaching the surface. So the amount of magnetic flux that rises up to the sun's surface varies with time in a cycle called the solar cycle. So this cycle lasts 11 years, please note this. This cycle is sometimes referred to as the sunspot cycle. So this is all about friends today's discussion of current affair MCQs. If you like the discussion, if you like the video, then do ensure that you like it, share it with your friends, and also ensure that you subscribe to our channel. And lastly friends, if in case you are interested to remain in touch with us, you can join our Telegram channel, the link of which is shown on your screen, and this will also be provided in the description box. So you can, if in case you are interested to remain in touch with us, with our updates, with our initiatives, then you are most welcome to join this public Telegram channel. And you can also visit our website, that is www.achieveias.co.in, where we keep on uploading important articles for your for the purpose of your preparation. So you can also mail us, or you can contact us at this given number if you have any queries. And lastly friends, if you want to get the PDFs of these MCQs, then you can contact us at these details, or you can also check the description box. So sorry, there is a minimum fee for it, for the PDFs, that is rupees 99 per month. So if in case you are interested, do ensure that you check the description box or contact us. So this fee has been kept just to ensure that we people remain motivated to help you people. So if in case you are interested, you are more than welcome to contact us, or you can check the description box. So this is all about today's video. Do ensure that you subscribe to our channel. So thank you friends, have a very nice day ahead.